To finish with the first technique, let us come back to the morphing of a triangle onto a circle. We have improved this file to go to 3D. We have created here, from a point of the intermediate curve, a segment here and a segment here. This segment, if you drag this point, you can see that this segment is always parallel to this one, but this one passes always through a fixed point. If we ask for the locus of each segment, we obtain this one and the upper curve here, but here we obtain not a prism but a pyramid. And if we change the parameters of this figure, we can change the size of the prism or the size or the aspect of the pyramid. Let's come back to the presentation. And we will see other techniques to improve the previous one. We'll see how to morph polygons onto polygons, and we will see how to morph a number onto another number, like this. We will have the details of the technique. Let's go to this file. So you can see here that I have a first polygon, which is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pentagon, and here a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 a decagon. And you can see that this red curve morphs you see that we cannot drag this point because this point can be commanded by this slider I have created. You can see that this slider, it's a segment, a point on this segment, and the number we have created is the ratio between this distance and the length of the segment, calculated here. How did we create this intermediate curve? We'll show now the technique in the next page. So you see that we have a point chosen on this pentagon, and we have created an array here, and you see that on this ray we have a point, and this point has been created with this slider as the image by the dilation centered here of this point, and this point it always at the ratio which is this number. So when we drag this point, this point will describe an intermediate curve solution of all the problem, the morphing of this polygon onto this one. So let us see the locus we have obtained, which is that. But the problem is that we have not all this curve, because when we create this intersection point with the decagon, doesn't exist here, because we have to create each time for each edge this construction. And what is this construction? So we use the tool dilation. So we go on dilation, centered on this point, of this point, with respect to this ratio, and we have this intermediate point. So we need now to get the locus of this point when this point moves, and we have the beginning of the intermediate curve. We have to do that for all edges, and you can see that if we drag this point, we morph the curve. If we come back to the previous page, you can see that we can drag this point. No, we can drag this point, and you can see that we can change the parameters of the figure to obtain exactly what we want. That was the morphing of a polygon. Let's go to the morphing of numbers. You can see that in this page we can morph number 1 onto number 3 like this, continuously. What is the technique? We'll not describe during a long time this technique, because the only difference with the first technique is the use of this slider. But to transform this segment onto this arc, we have used this construction. We have constructed a ray from this point, and we have created this point, which is the image. And after that, we have used the dilation centered here of this point with respect to this one. And we did it for the three parts of one, this part, and this part. It will be more interesting to describe what happened in the next file, where we morphed 2 on 4. How did we do that? It's more interesting to see it now. And you see that it seems more complicated. We have our slider here, and we will focus our attention on the morphing of this blue segment onto this arc. You can notice that we have measured, first of all, this segment and this arc. You have the measure here. We have calculated the number by which we have to multiply CD to obtain the length of arc CD, which is 1.4, obtained by this division, A divided by B. After that, we have created a point P here, measured CP here, and use this formula to multiply this number by 1.4 to obtain this number, which will be the length of the arc CP. And to obtain point P, we have used the tool measurement transfer, not on the arc, but on the circle, which is behind this arc, and we obtain this point. When we did, after we have done that, we create this segment, and we finish with the tool dilation to construct the image of this point by the dilation centered here and with respect to this number. And you can see that we have morphed exactly what we wanted. Let's finish this part.